Well, married couple Mark and Sam were proving too powerful in the game of Survivor. They were the only remaining couple in the game with two hidden immunity idols. And on top of that, Mark won immunity 2 days in a row.
Yeah, but in the end, Jordie got his revenge and sent home one of the biggest players in the game.
If anyone has a hidden immunity idol and you'd like to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Mark, play it for Sam. Or I'm telling you.
Why? Okay. I'll read the votes. Come on. 16th person voted out of blood versus water. Sam.
Sam. Sam joins us now live from the Dandenong Ranges. I was watching that. I was going, play it. Sam, you and Mark had two idols. Josh told you to play it. Why didn't you play one last night?
I mean, guys, firstly, great to speak to you. So good to see you. Hi, Sam.
We're so invested.
Hi, Tristan. Hi, Sarah. you know, my whole game was about being really strategic and thinking long-term. And if I played that idol then, it was a short-term play. We would have retained our threat level of being the only couple in the game. Mm. And on top of it, we would never have known where to play the idols because it would always been like, should I play it on Mark? Should we play it on me? And so it actually created clarity and simplicity for Mark moving forward because now he has two for himself, which is essentially himself is ourself because we're a team. Mm. And I can do the next phase of the game, the jury.
There we go.
And you're kind of already in the game still, aren't you? Because Mark's still in there and, you know, as you said, you're one and the same. And how hungry will Mark be, do you think, for revenge?
Hopefully not too hungry for revenge because I don't think revenge is a smart gameplay. I think revenge is really short term. You have to actually work with people that have burnt you because the game, I think, is about being fluid. And yeah, I hopefully, you know, he's obviously going to be angry. He's going to have a bit of fire in the belly. That's all great because that keeps you focused. But hopefully he just keeps thinking, that was our strategy. We were fine with me going. Now just keep making smart plays to get to the end.
There you go. And that's what they are. They're all smart plays. Mm. People forget it's a game sometimes. One of your most bold moves in this game was when you convinced Jesse to hand over his idol. How did you land on that move? And I know, I'm sure you felt a little bit bad about that.
Yeah, I mean, the Samantha of me feels really bad about it because I adore Jesse as a person and we're really, really good mates on this outside world. But in the game, firstly, it wasn't premeditated, but it was incredibly opportunistic. And it lent into the fact that, you know, Survivor is also about, you know, outplaying and outwitting. And I was okay to lean into that villainy because I wanted to play this game. Like, it's a pretty exciting, fun, on the edge of your seat kind of gameplay. So the player of me is proud. I wish it wasn't Jesse that I was doing it to. But on top of that, Jesse and I weren't working as much together once we got to merge because we both had our partners in the game and Jordie had already flipped on Mark by telling everyone about his idol. So, you know, he had to go.
You have the most incredible game face, Sam. Have you ever considered, like, a career in politics?
My game face is terrible. Like, I think you can see emotion all over me. I mean, I think you can make a cartoon character out of my face. I tried to be a bit more calm in the face. I definitely wear my emotions, you know, very visibly. But the funny thing is, like, no one really asked me if I had Jesse's idol. So I very rarely had to talk about it. Everyone talked about it around me and I kind of just nodded my head and said, yeah, why would someone put an idol in your bag? But only one person ever directly asked me, do I have Jesse's idol?
Yeah. Mm. And that would have been from your experiences.
It's not technically lying, it's just a mission.
Well, and your experiences from being on the show before as well. You need to use that experience. Mm-hmm. Sam, we have everyone... huge fans of Survivor. So they've thrown in a couple of questions, if you'd mind answering some for us.
Love to.
Fantastic. Do you want to kick it off?
Yeah, Marlene. Marlene asks this. Why didn't you play Jesse's idol for him?
Okay. Jesse and I weren't really playing heavily together. He was with Jordie, and Jordie was working essentially against my husband. So as much as I love Jesse, I had known him for 30 days. I was there to play with my husband who we're married and he doesn't share a bank account. I'm not going to do anything to detriment my husband and therefore my game.
Yeah, fair enough.
There we go.
That's a good answer.
And we want to know if Mark has been thinking the same, because our next one comes from Survivor superfan and friend of the show, Jeff Quattromani. Jeff asks, did Mark share a chip or anything in the auction challenge? You, of course, got a slice of Vegemite toast.
I think they just wanted me to starve on that show. That whole, I was there for 40 days, and outside of beans and rice, I had one croissant, one hot dog, and I feel like that caterpillar game, the book that you do in the kitchen, yes. Had one hot dog, and I had the merge feast. So I really, I didn't win the immunity challenges at the end to be able to get it, but I also wasn't taken along to those rewards. So I was pretty hungry, and Mark did great with the steak. I'm sure that helped him in that final challenge. And I'm just like, I can't even throw, the throwing bag.
Well, finally, Jenna has this question. Were you nervous about entering the jury after all your big moves?
Yes, and I think everyone should go and watch Jury Villa episode on Fenplay to see the frosty reception that I received. It was full on. I was proud of my game, but I knew there was consequence to be had for the plays that I made, and essentially sitting in that jury with the people who I was in an alliance with but turned against once I joined my game with Mark and we had a different strategy together. So it wasn't pleasant. But it didn't take long before I got to explain my game, and people are hurt and you have to let people be hurt. But I think once you kind of go, and I said this to them, I said, I'm here, I played a game, you guys all played the game, we were all there to win, but I'm now here with all of you. So ask any questions that you have and I'll tell you the truth. And, very quickly relationships reformed. And the thing is, even though we're playing what in many respects is a bit of a toxic game, personal relationships are real out there, because you're living this shared experience through adversity and it does bond you in a very unique way together.
Yeah, you're right. Assuming now, Sam, that Mark is the one to beat, who, if anyone, has what it takes to beat?
To beat him?
Yeah.
I mean, everyone has a unique game. The question is, do people back that person's game? Some people play really passively. So you see players like KJ and Shay and Chrissy who have played a more passive game, but obviously they've done something to stay there. And so if they can speak to it strongly, they have a great claim to Soul Survivor. You've got people like Jordie and Mark who are playing, and Josh, much more active gameplay. So I just think everyone has a case, and it depends how they argue it, and it depends, every jury member has their own respective vote. So I think it's anyone's game.
There we go.
Oh, you're brilliant. Australian Survivor, Blood versus Water, continues Sunday night at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Sam, thanks again for joining us, and we'll see you soon.
Thanks so much, everyone. I love the show, and you too.